Available for download right now from the Microsoft Live website is the first application that uses the Sea Dragon interface. It's still very much a prototype and you can't do a lot with it, but the potential is there. It's called Photosynth, and as you can see, it uses the Sea Dragon interface. So we have pictures that we can move into and that we can move around, and we can go and have a look at any of these pictures. I should say these pictures aren't mine. These were all taken from the FlickR website, which is a photo sharing site, and are all there for download by members of the public. And that's what Microsoft did. They went onto FlickR and downloaded any pictures that related to St. Mark's Square in Venice. But this isn't the interesting bit. The interesting bit is if you come out of that and into the 3D view. Because in the 3D view, you can interact with the images in a completely different way. So we can move around St. Mark's Square. And what Photosynth does is to look for similarities in the pictures and then work out and map where they all go. And it creates its own 3D virtual environment. So these are all different pictures taken by people that have never met each other, all at Venice at different times, but all photographing the same things. And it finds overlaps and joins and then finds pictures that are the same. And you can move in and out as well. Anywhere where you see one of these little white squares is another picture that you can click on. So for example, if I want to see more detail in the centre of the basilica there, I can move in by finding another picture and another view, and go in and zoom right in. So I can zoom right in and see all that close detail. So much more detail than I could have taken if I just had a single picture of my own. And you can step backwards as well, so we can step away from the picture and backwards a bit further. And every picture is somebody else's image, unrelated, unconnected, but Photosynth has joined them all together, and so on. And you can move around the picture as well. So let's have a little look at the Campanelle there. We can have a look at different angles. We can zoom in a little bit on the top. We can use the scroll wheel to zoom in, just like we were doing with Sea Dragon. We can see people up there looking down at us taking pictures. All of these pictures aren't on my computer. These are all on the internet, and they're all streaming live from the internet. I have a reasonably fast broadband, but it's nothing special, nothing that anybody else wouldn't have. And you can move around here. There is no freezing, no pausing. Here we are now. We've jumped up onto the roof. Let's see if we can take a little look around from one of the balconies here. Here we go. Now we can look down into St. Mark's Square, and we can zoom in. We can zoom right in. You could even count all the pigeons if you wanted, like so. It's only a prototype at the moment, so you only get one picture at a time. But there are things you can do. You can have a 3D flyover, so we can fly over St. Mark's Square and have a look all the way around it. That will probably run a little bit jerky on the video, we'll have to see. But you can do that again and just pause it anywhere, so we can stop there. Now, this 3D model is generated by looking at the pictures and the computer working out a shape. This hasn't been programmed in, it's purely worked out by the photographs that it found that fitted the model. And we can click on any of these pictures, you can see lots of squares, and zoom right in. So we can go and see that picture, for example. Another thing that you can do with Photosynth is to turn the cameras on. So if we click on the cameras, you now see lots of little orange squares if we zoom down into them, little orange things, and when you hover over them, it'll show you where the camera was pointing. So they've worked out where the picture was actually taken from. So that one, for example, is a picture of, well, a little bit of the basilica and a lot of a bucket of champagne by the looks of things. They're all different pictures. Let's move across this one. Here we are, look. That was taken with somebody obviously sitting at one of the cafes. There's one over here. That's taken looking up at some detail of the Doge's Palace by the looks of things. And so you can move around. You can look at every camera angle. You can work out where people were standing and what they were photographing. And of course you can move in and out of any of these pictures and interact with it. You can always go back to the Sea Dragon view and pick different pictures that way as well. So there are lots of different ways that this software can be used and interactive. And the idea is that it makes the internet a smaller place. It makes all of our photos join together so we become part of one big photographic community.